इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 11। सो आउट ऑफ टू नंबर सॉरी टू नंबर्स आर सेलेक्टेड एट रैंडम फ्रॉम द इंटीजर्स 1 to 9। इफ द सम ऑफ द नंबर्स इज इवन, द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट बोथ द नंबर्स आर ऑड। सो गिवन दैट द सम इज इवन एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दैट बोथ द नंबर्स प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ बोथ द नंबर्स आर ऑड। सो हेयर आई हैव रिटन द आउटकम्स 1,2, 1,3, 1,4, 1,5 अप टू 1,9, देन 2,1, 2,3 अप टू 2,9, देन 3,1, 3,2, 3,4, 3,5। सो सिमिलरली अप टू टोटल वी विल हैव 64 आउटकम्स, राइट? लेट ए बी द इवेंट दैट द सम इज इवन नंबर। सो 1,3 इज इवन, 1,5 इज इवन, 1,7 इज इवन, 1,9 इज इवन। सिमिलरली 2,3 इज इवन, सॉरी 2,4 इज इवन, 2,6 is even and 2,8 is even. So total 7 outcomes are there in 2 rows. So total there are 9 rows. So in 4 rows, 7 multiplied by 4, 28, plus 9th row we'll have 4 outcomes in which sum is even. 9,1, 9,3, 9,5, 9,7, right? So this will be 32. Now let B be the event in which odd numbers are there, right? Both odd numbers are there. So 1,3, 1,5, 1,7, 1,9. In two row we'll have no such outcome. So similarly in third row, fifth row and seventh row. So total 4 multiply 4, 4 multiply 5 we have 20, because in ninth row also we'll have. So total outcomes 20. So A intersection B, A intersection B means sum should be even number and the number should be odd. So this is 20, right? From here if we'll pick the numbers, we'll have 20 such numbers. So probability of probability of B, given that A has already occurred, is probability of A intersection B upon probability of A, right? So probability of A intersection B is 20 upon 64 upon probability of A is 32 upon 64. So 64 to 64 get cancelled. 20 upon 32 is 10 upon 16, 5 upon 8. This was quite a tricky question and quite a lengthy question. So try to understand it carefully. First write down all the total outcomes, then outcomes in set A, then outcomes in set B, and then A intersection B, and then find the probability. Now this is a question. A family has two children. What is the conditional probability that both are boys? So both are boys given that youngest is a boy. So youngest is a boy, how many outcomes are there? One, youngest is a boy. So first, capital girl means capital alphabets means elder, and small alphabets means younger. So both are youngest is a boy, how many outcomes are there? 1 and 2, right? So probability of both boys given that youngest is boy is a boy, right? So this will be equal to probability of both boys intersection youngest is a boy. So both boys intersection youngest is a boy will be this one outcome only, right? Both boys, and I'll write it here, youngest is a boy will have outcomes this girl comma boy and boy comma boy, right? The smaller one is a boy, youngest is a boy. Similarly, both boys is equal to boy comma boy, right? Similarly, next one is at least one is a boy. So at least one is a boy outcomes. At least one is a boy. Outcomes are this, this and this. So girl comma boy comma boy comma boy comma boy comma girl, right? At least one is a boy. Now let's do the question. So probability of both boys upon youngest is a boy, so this will be equal to both boy given youngest is a boy, right? So both boys intersection youngest is a boy, so this is the intersection, right? B comma B is common in these two, so probability of this will be 1/4 because total outcomes are 1 2 3 4, upon probability of youngest is a boy, so youngest is a boy probability is two outcomes are there, so 2/4, right? 4 to 4 get cancelled, answer is 1/2. Similarly, next is probability of both boys, given that at least one is a boy. One is a boy. So intersection of these two, both boys and this intersection will be B comma B. So probability is 1/4 upon at least one is a boy. So at least one is a boy, outcomes are these three. So 3/4, right? So 4 to 4 get cancelled, answer is 1/3. Just remember probability formula, number of outcomes upon total number of outcomes. So total number of outcomes are 4 from here, right? And number of outcomes according to the situation, we are taking it from here. So 1/4 means 1 is the number of outcome upon total outcome is 4. Similarly, 2/4. So this is the way we have done this question. Next, question number 13. Now this is question number 13. So probability of A is accountancy. A student passes in accountancy is 80%. So 80/100 is 4/5. A student passes in business mathematics is 90%, so 90/100, 9/10. A student passes in both is 70%, so 7/10. Now we have to find out the probability that a student passed in business mathematics given that he also passed in accountancy. So this will be equal to probability of A intersection B upon probability of A, right, according to the formula. This is 7/10. Upon probability of A is 4/5, or we can say 8/10 also. So this will be 7/8. 7/8 is our answer, right? This is question number 13th. I'll show you from here also. This is question number 13th. Now next is question number 14th. In a school there are 1000 students, out of which 470 are boys, right? So boys are 470, total students are 1000. Now class 11 students are 10% of boys, so 10% of 470 is 47. So we have to find out the probability that a student is chosen randomly studies in class 11th given that the chosen student is a boy. So given that it is a boy, so this will be probability of class 11th intersection boy upon probability of boy, right? So probability of class 11th intersection boy, so 10% of the students are in class 11th, 10% of boys are in class 11th, right? So 47 students out of 470 are in class 11th. 47, probability of 11th intersection boy will be 47 upon 1000. So 47/1000 upon probability of boys is 470/1000. So 1000 to 1000 get cancelled. So 47/470, which is 1/10. So 1/10 is the answer of question number 14th, right? So next is question number 15th. So question number 15th, we have a bag contains 10 white balls and 15 black balls, right? So white balls is equal to 10, black balls is equal to 15, right? Two balls are drawn in succession without replacement. What is the probability that first is a white and second is a black? Now two balls are drawn, probability that first is a white and second is a black. Probability of second is a black given that first one is white, right? This we have to determine, right? So let's see the outcomes. If two balls are determined, right, two balls are taken out. So probability of first one is white will be 10 upon 25, right? Similarly, probability of first one is black will be 15 upon 25, right? Probability of second one is white. Now, given that probability of second one is white, given that first one is white, right? So first one we have already taken out. So one ball is already taken out from this ball. So how many balls are remaining? 9 balls are remaining only, right? Out of this 10, only 9 balls are remaining. So out of 9, 1 is also taken out again. So 9 upon total outcomes will be 15 plus 9, 24, right? So we have to find out probability that the second ball is black and the first ball is white. Similarly, probability of second ball is black and first ball is white. So second ball is black and first ball is white. So second ball is black. So how many black balls are there? Because in the first outcome, we have taken out only white ball. So in second outcome, we'll have 15 black balls, right? Upon total white ball, total balls will be 15 plus 9, 24. So 15 upon 24 is 5 upon 8. So 5 upon 8 is our answer. Probability of second ball is black and first ball is white. So first ball we have taken out first. Probability of first ball we have taken out and second ball is black, right? So this is the probability of second ball is black given that first ball is white. Now, what is the probability that the first ball is white? First ball is white, probability is 10 upon 15, 10 upon 25. This we have taken out, right? So let's try to understand this in this way. Probability of second ball is white, second ball is black given that first ball is white. So first ball is white. What is the probability that the first ball we have picked is white? This is 10 upon 25. Now second draw, in the second draw we are picking one ball again. So one ball again, how many black balls are there? 15 black balls are there. But how many total balls are there? Because one ball we have already taken out, that is white. So 24 balls are there, right? So 15 three times, 15 five times, sorry, 5 three times, 15, 5, 5 times, 25, 5 one time, 5 two time, 3 one time, 3, 3 eight time, 2 one time, 2 four times. So answer is 1 by 4, which is 0.25. So this question is quite important and a different type, different category question. So try to understand this question very carefully. So this was all about today's video. In the next video, we will be solving further questions. I'll show you the picture of the questions. Just hold on. Try to do these questions at your home. Right? So question number, till question number 15, we have done. Question number 16 is related to this question. Then 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, and then 23 and 24, 25. So number of questions are there from this chapter. Okay, so thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.